So, welcome back to Crystal River Romp. Last time, Audrey and Drachma got to experience love for the first time.
I love the broken leg, trying not to laugh.
It was beautiful.
You're allowed to laugh. It's the daily, it's the session joke.
No, fun here. We don't like fun here, Kat. They can't
laugh
ever.
No, we get no fun here because this time we go 5 years in the past where a woman is running as New York begins to sink. And behind her shows a girl.
Give me a moment. Hold up. The little girl is running close to her mother, and...
I wouldn't...
15. It's okay. Little. This small girl is just running with her, feeling panic, not knowing what words to say, but tries to go and hold her mother's hand, seeing if they can both run as fast as they can.
Both. Run. Trying to make it to where your car was parked. As this just seemed to come out of the blue.
What's going on?
It's all right. We gotta keep moving.
I can see that, but what happened?
As you two approach the cars, a loud crash comes from the building in front of you, and your mother looks up and shoves you.
Mom! No!
As the building comes down.
Does Audrey see any way besides smoke and mirrors?
No. You get concrete just peppers your skin, and you can feel like some bits just cut into your skin, and you can feel the blood start to trickle down.
She'll look at the ground. Mom. No. No. Mom? Fuck. She's just gonna stay there. No. And fall to her knees. Crying.
As the entirety of New York City is rumbling from something. It's almost like constant earthquakes, and rivulets of energy run throughout the floor around you, and as the dust clears from the building collapsing, and you see just the hand there in the dust, you see something else glimmering amongst the rubble for just a split second. You... That's strange. Is that almost where you saw her ghost escape her body?
Audrey would see this figure. She doesn't know what to feel, but she'll try to reach and grab her. No. I don't... Please don't leave. Please.
The figure, whatever it is, the ghost, dives in and out of the building and comes to the edge of it. You can barely see it, but there's a small, almost, well, smile as it looks at you. A hand sticks out of the side of the building.
Audrey is going to reach for the hand, shaking.
as you reach for the hand, and this figure fades. You grasp for it, but all that's left in your hand is a framed photograph of your mother.
She holds it to her chest. I'm so sorry. Failed you.
And for some reason, as you hold this picture close to you, even though this moment is incredibly traumatic, it's soothing. You feel a resolve flush through your body.
And eventually, as Audrey sits there clutching the photograph, she's evac'd out. Back to home. Where it's just her and her father now, who has been dealing with her mother's death in a very different way.
Audrey isn't going to do anything. Let's just write on a notebook and just hum under her breath. She draws a picture of her mother with flowers around her.
And as you're drawing, your father walks in the door, slams the door, mumbles something in his drunken state, looks at you.
She's just not gonna look at her father and sighs.
He just looks at you and sighs and shakes his head, takes another swig from whatever the fuck he's drinking, and walks up the stairs. You hear every footstep and every stumble. And a moment later, you hear a little voice.
Hey. Hey.
She turns around. Does she know who it is?
No, you've never seen this thing in your life.
She'll just see this awful looking plant and be like, oh sweet Jesus, and just move.
It looks almost like it's withering or wilting. It slowly tilts its head towards you.
She's very confused from what she sees. Given another look, is it really just weathered?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Do you need water? Or and plant food?
It tries to bite your hand as you reach down to it.
She'll quickly grab it out of reach of his jaws and just back up a bit. Hey!
Green. Feed me.
Well, it just walks close again. Well, how do I feed you? I said water, so I'm trying to get water.
No water.
It looks at your hand. It looks at you.
You want a hand?
Yeah.
Are you pinky? It
slowly wiggles towards you. Squeaking in the pot. There's probably at this moment like a thump upstairs and you wonder to yourself, did anyone else put this here? How'd this plant get here?
She was in the chair the entire time. There was no plant pot behind that chair at all. She just slaps her face a little bit. Come on, it's a talking plant. Opens her eye again. Is it still there?
Still there?
Yeah.
You are real. What's your name?
Audrey. Give me food.
I know. I just want to know your name first.
Can't eat names.
No eating names.
Man, got it.
You don't have a name.
No god can probably hate if had.
He's going to just look at her hand and bite a little section of her thumb to let it bleed a little bit. Kind of like a feeling of, is this what he wants?
Okay, it starts to get down almost in a primal pouncing position. Like the tongue. It has a tongue, by the way. That's a plant with a tongue. The tongue, like, flicks out and wraps around your pinky.
She'll somehow be okay with this? And let him suck her finger?
It dives at your hand. Its mouth goes onto your hand like a fucking glove, and it starts biting at your wrist.
No! She's going to run and swing Little Chop out of her hand. No! Get off me! And she's going to swing hard and probably hit the TV by accident.
Little Shop is smashed into the fucking TV. He hangs out, the pot just like falling down very slightly.
Oh crap, the TV. He's gonna run to TV and push the plant away. No, bad. Push.
Little Shop lays on the floor dazed.
Do I feel dazed too after
yeah,
that?
Yeah, you do.
Oh god. She'll just lay on the floor, just tired. You eat blood. What can be worse than that? Like a little shop of horrors right there, man.
Oh, credit!
Are you serious?
She gets this little smirk. I'll keep you safe, buddy.
Even after you smashed it into a television, it looks brighter, more vibrant, and green, and that's odd. Did it get slightly larger? And it coughs. It sounds like it's choking, and it spits up a little bobby pin.
Ah, that's fitting. Okay. Not too long after. Neighbors report smelling rotten flesh, and the cops come to investigate. And they find Audrey's dad partially eaten from an animal of some kind, they think. And Audrey is nowhere to be found.
Everybody, Little Shop of Horrors.
Oh, yay.
Baby plant. That's just hard to say.
I didn't do it. Audrey, you gotta believe me.
Hey,
this literal newborn baby is giving off bad vibes.
We're gonna
universe, that's Colin.
Come back to the present, as you all have decided to come to Wizardtopia.
Oh shit. What?
Thank you, Tali. Hello. Thank you for hitting music.
I do want to preface this with one thing. As you walk down the park, having finally caught up with your horses and put them in the appropriate stable like you were supposed to. You continue down into Wizardtopia theme park and attraction, where in the distance you can slightly smell the scent of concession food wafting across your nostrils.
Well, that was... oh, exhausting! So exhausting!
Alright, let's, as I was saying, salt is the worst possible thing to put on any kind of food.
I disagree with that.
Yeah, definitely paprika. It's definitely paprika. Paprika is the absolute worst.
How dare you?
No, it's salt.
There. She just walks away from
that. Both of you are wrong.
Oh? What's your opinion, King?
I really can't, because I tasted every different food and every different seasoning. And they all taste delicious.
Touché.
It depends on how it's made, not on how much it's in it.
Audrey is just going to keep walking away from these people. They don't know anything about good food. Just keeps walking.
Alan, it seems like we have been outsmarted.
You hear,
yeah, man! Theme parks are the best shit in the world!
As this guy comes down walking with, like, a 20-foot-tall stack of ice cream cones.
I thought you were going to say 20-foot hot dog.
Maybe it's both. It might be ice cream with hot dogs sticking out of it. They call it the hot dog float.
Audrey wants to go and ask, excuse me, good sir.
Mm?
Where do you get that ice cream that you have right there?
He angles a finger.
Concessions. They're like, I don't know if you had eyes like 10 feet from me.
Okay.
He keeps walking.
She's gonna do something really dumb.
Oh,
little
no.
Shop.
No!
I kind of want him to be back right here. Like, right there.
There's a bed of flowers.
Uh-huh.
Oh, I do.
Wherever you want.
I have a little shop. Before he left, tried to scoop up the ice cream and then disappear. Then reappear with the ice cream in her pockets.
Ice cream pockets.
I'll roll for this guy to notice little shop. Or no, wait, he can't see it. There's no way. Does this guy just lose?
I feel like this is low stakes enough that it can just like auto win.
Good as the one, they said it was a triple tower stack, not a double. Ah, whatever, it's good as hell.
He keeps walking.
Question, Audrey.
I love this Mord cameo.
Did you get?
She gives a little smirk to King,
yeah.
And scoops under her pocket. Hey, little shop, did you do it right?
Yeah.
It's sucking on a hot dog.
She'll take one of the ice creams. Oh man, how many scoops did I took from him?
One of the triple scoop.
Dang it.
Hey, strawberry? You got strawberry in there?
I'm gonna plot point this. She has a beaker and puts the ice cream in the beaker.
Please put the hot dog.
You guys
dog
want
in
some?
What? What dark
I'll put the hot dog. Hot dog and ice cream in the beaker. Here, some. And hands it to either both King and Alan just to see who grabs it first.
Me.
Alan slowly backs away.
Alan, wait!
Hey, where you think you're going? This is some delicious food over here, man.
Well, I wouldn't say delicious. I would say free food, but it's okay.
I don't know that... I don't know a combination of... Why can you think that's alright? That's not alright. Why is there ice cream in the hot dog?
Don't ask questions you need to answer to.
That is because... Misney Planet is for special people that know good taste. I don't like it, but maybe some people here do.
Audrey, you've noticed that you don't know where the little shop is anymore.
Oh no!
Can I see little shop from where I'm at?
No, you actually can't. Little shop, for the viewer's reference, has ducked down behind this concession stall. It is completely out of sight right now.
I see the concession owner will soon die.
Audrey is just gonna sigh, take her finger, and bite it hard to bleed. Little shop.
Hey, what the heck? Why? Audrey, you're bleeding. Audrey, oh.
Stop. Drachma, calm
down.
Like a
one potted rodent, little shop crawls around the corner.
I smell blood.
Blood.
Yes, you do. She sighs and aims it at him. Come back here and you'll get it.
Drachma looks over. Wow, I didn't know sharks also came in plant variety.
It bounces over.
Don't ask.
He's gonna smile and take Little Shop by her arms like a little pet and pats it in the head.
As you do step over here, you guys do notice that there is a buy one, get one free sale opportunity at this concession stand.
Ooh, buy one, get one free.
Audrey does not want any part of it, thinking Little Shop is just gonna cause any trouble.
Wait, what is buy one, get one free? What's buy one, get one free?
Oh, it's get buy one ice cream, get one hot dog combined into it for free.
Now I want a slushie. I feel like a slushie right now.
You can go get a slushie. I'm just gonna go away so that Little Shop is in no trouble. And she looks right dead right here. Ah, the beautiful roses.
Ma'am, can I get a slushie? Red flavor?
Huh? What?
A slushy, red flavored.
I didn't know red was a flavor.
You know what I mean. Strawberry,
yeah,
cherry.
Sure. That'll be $3.50.
Here you go.
He goes back to make the slushy. Here.
Thank you, ma'am. I hope you have a wonderful day.
Yeah, sure.
As King buys his slushy, Audrey looks at Drachma. Oh, I didn't know you were just here.
King.
She didn't even notice him come
King,
over.
King, you feel something wet on your shirt. You look down. Oh, there's teeth marks in that cup.
Oh my god.
Little Shop, you mess with my favorite drink in the whole world.
No. Little Shop, say you're sorry.
Come here, Little Shop. I will make you drink this. You wasted
no,
my
no,
money.
That's a bad idea, King. Please. Please?
Now, everybody. I think there's a... I believe there's a really easy way to do this, and it's just for Little Shop to say his sorry and for King to... Oh. Alan.
Yeah?
How do you get flushy stains out of a kimono?
I can eat your shirt for you.
No.
I
would not know this information.
And everybody.
Yes, we did. It'll help later.
At this moment,
yes.
You hear the sound of footsteps approaching behind you, as you see somebody start to run up behind you. Not run up, really, more just a hurried head down, holding something glowing slightly in her hands.
Yeah.
Well, listen, maybe I can talk into... Drachma moves over to try to get to Little Shop, accidentally bumps it down.
Perfect! Yeah, okay. You bump into her air quote accidentally, and she just falls on her ass on the ground, and there's like... Drachma, make a bronze roll.
Yee-hoo! I'm in danger!
Can I roll for it? Can I roll to see it?
To see... what?
What was Drachma looking at?
Oh, Drachma just backed into this person and they both fell on the ground. King, as you look back though, you do notice that she clutched something close to her chest as if she almost dropped it, but didn't. Just looks over at Drachma. Oh, I'm so sorry.
No, it's my fault completely. I didn't know where I was going. She helps her up. He helps her up.
She accepts the hand graciously. Thank you.
Sorry about that. My name's Drachma, Romani Facilier. I'm... nice to meet you, I guess? Sorry for bumping into you.
She kind of sheepishly, like, looks to the side. I'm Peppa. And now that you're looking at this woman up close, you realize... she's... carrying something in her hands that seems to be gently glowing.
Thinks back to the S symbol. See if the glow seems similar.
The S symbol wasn't glowing, was it?
It was an S. It was just a piece of metal.
Excuse me, ma'am. I'm so sorry about my friend here. He's very clumsy sometimes, and here, and she gives her a rose. Have one. Please, as a token of apology.
See, I'm very sorry.
Sure. Pepper takes the rose, looks at Audrey, kind of scratches the back of her head. You all, first time at Misney?
Oh, and I'm really happy to be here. It's so awesome. It's so amazing. I've already had a great time. I've already met these two people, and I'm also very happy. Drachma continues like this, like talking excitedly about how happy he is to be here.
Drachma, it's okay. We're super excited, but also, yes, it's mainly our first time here, and, I'm just wondering if you know the best place to go. Us four to go and have fun.
Well, she thinks for a moment. I always did like the bumper cars.
Sounds amazing.
Yeah. Never been in a bumper car.
Audrey's gonna give Alan like a weird look of, you see the thing by her? Does she see what's on her hand, or that she's clutching something that seems important, quotation marks?
Alan nods.
As you think that, Drachma just says out loud, oh, by the way, what do you have in your hand there?
She like eyes me for a moment. She taps.
I'm just asking because I didn't want to be, I knocked into you, and I don't want to be the one that damaged it. I'm so sorry again if I damaged it.
Calm down, it's alright.
Really?
Yeah, I'm just simply a park representative. Happen to have, these, she does not open her hand but holds them close. Potentially dangerous objects I confiscated off of two park goers.
Does it look anything like this? He takes out the S symbol.
Oh, no, that's in my inventory.
Oh.
Rip.
Alan, can I borrow something real quick, please? Please.
What is it?
Yes, the thing we found off.
Ah, okay. He, takes out what appears to be a wallet, opens it up, there's no money in it, there's no, like, information, it's just an empty wallet, except for the S symbol. He hands it to him.
Oh, thank you. Does it look anything like this? He pulls up the key item.
She looks at it, she blinks. No, never seen that in my life. Is that like a superhero pin or something?
We found it off of Robot Frog.
A robot?
Why are you giving it to people?
Frog. Right. One more thing to investigate. She rubs temples. She's gonna say, yes, well, there seems to be some things going on. I wanted to ask, well, since you all seem to be so excitable and new.
You can say bizarre if you want to.
Bizarre works. You wouldn't happen to know anyone who was given a red ticket, would you?
Oh, you mean like this? He says, taking out his.
Dude.
Drachma is oblivious to King's suffering.
Drachma gives away all the information, not PNG. Okay.
Drachma, if interrogated, will spill literally every life detail he has.
I love him. She nods as you pull out the ticket. Yes, precisely. It would seem that you four are... Well, I'm assuming you four traveled together, yes? Did all of you receive one of these?
I know that...
At different times.
I know that me and my cousin over here did. You have one too, right, Alan?
Yep. Take it out.
Do any of you know who gave you those tickets? Or why?
My family didn't tell me who gave it to me.
I received mine in the mail and, like, well, it was my first time going, so I was really excited, but, I did find it kind of weird that, well, I did find it kind of weird that my moms were so excited for me to go, too. They're usually kind of, what's the way to put it? I don't want to make this sound mean. Protective. Yeah, that's it.
Can I blonde Drachma in the head?
Yeah, make a bronze roll.
I'm not gonna try to do any damage to him. It is gonna be a small blonde.
You should have waited until it all finished, Drachma. And sighs and walks away.
Huh?
I'll catch you guys up, okay?
What? Drachma and Alan go, what?
Gives you like that sigh of disappointment and just walks away and just gives you guys like a hand signal of, I'll be right back. I want to find food, and walks to find food.
What was that about?
Little Shop, however, is going to boop, where she holds the rose at the little teeny tiny Little Shop.
Oh, Little Shop's staying on Pepper?
Yeah.
Interesting. Pepper doesn't seem to notice that Little Shop jumps on her at all.
Drachma just eyeing Little Shop like,
don't you dare say anything.
I guess walking forward, I see this thingy here.
It mostly looks like just a do not enter. This is a construction zone with some two very bored guards. Smith arrows.
Alright. Pepper looks at Drachma. I'm, honestly, you're the first person to give me straight information. Thank you so much. Drachma, I mean, like, was?
Yeah, it's amazing to meet you. Hey, can we be friends?
Yeah, sure.
Yes. She chuckles. He does a little fist pump. He just seems so happy.
Good to have a friend in the neighborhood, yeah? Are you, from around here?
No, I come from, I come from insert town name here, and insert state name here. It's a far ways away. This is actually, he gets a little serious, this is weird. This is actually my first time ever outside of there.
Oh.
Yeah, I haven't had a life that was conducive to getting out much, you could say. I've always, just spent most of my time with family and, well, shifty eyes, friends. But I guess you could say that this is one of my first times to ever just have fun. And well, I hope you're having fun.
She eyes the others, looks down. Things could be better, but...
Oh, do you need help then? I'm willing to help.
I kinda figured you'd say that. Just keep an eye out for more people with these red tickets, and if you ever do figure out who gave you them to begin with, contact us. She hands you a number.
Oh, okay. He hands her his number.
Wonderful.
And if you ever need help, don't feel free to call. I help friends whenever I can.
Of course. It's... It's good to have a friend around here. So, hopefully you'll accept a friend like me.
Drachma looks at her kind of shocked. What are you talking about? You're awesome.
I'm glad you think that.
Oh no, it's not that I think that, it's the truth.
She smiles. Well, very well then, Drachma.
Stay safe, Pepper.
You too. He's going to start walking off and puts her hands in her pockets and kind of smiles to herself.
As she's walking off, Drachma's going to say, oh, one last thing.
Mm-hmm. She turns her head and looks back.
Before Drachma says anything, I want to know, did she put the rose in the pocket as well?
The pocket with Little Shop?
Little Shop.
Yeah, she did.
I'm gonna do something so incredibly dumb, but also Audrey's.
Well,
stupid-
then I have a question, Tali. Hmm? Does she put them in separate pockets?
The rose in Little Shop?
The rose and what she's holding. The thing that she was holding the entire time.
Oh, those are still in her hand.
Oh, okay.
There's a ticket in that pocket.
I'm gonna tell, from what I imagined, Little Shop, I want him to find something interesting about this woman. ID, anything that seems peculiar for Audrey's curiosity.
Do you want to roll a Little Shop precision? Oh, hot damn. Audrey.
Yes.
You're not gonna notice immediately, but when Little Shop gets back to you later, Little Shop notices that Pepper smells strange, or maybe that's not the best way to put it. It's almost like she doesn't smell at all. It's weird. You're not really sure how to describe it. But first, Drachma.
While talking, Drachma's been doing something. He's been looking for ghosts. Oh. It's unconscious. Is there anything near Pepper?
A ghost?
Traces of ghosts, like, anything like that. It's what he's used to, after all.
No.
Okay. Drachma just says, you can also just call if you want to talk. Not everything has to be about work or transactions or anything. Friends can just be friends.
Tell that to my boss.
Okay, give me his number.
She, like, crosses her eyes and, like, turns full around and, like, stares at you.
What?
And then, it, like, does a smile, winks. No.
Okay. Have a great day.
God, Jesus.
She turns back around and waves at Drachma as she walks away, still smiling.
I wave too. He's smiling like he always is.
They're so wholesome. I love them.
Guys, did I accidentally go into the pepper root?
The pepper root?
Pepper.
Yeah, King and Alan?
King and Alan. Alright. Alan tilts his hat down a little bit. Alright, we need to talk about serious things. You can tell I'm being serious right now because I'm tilting my hat down instead of up.
I can see that. It doesn't make you look any more menacing.
It does make me more menacing, I think. Anyway, about the frog. Did you mean to kill that frog, or...?
When I get mad, I don't really do what I don't have a right mind, I just kill whatever I want when I get mad. Or something makes me...
Alan has a visible reaction to that statement. Like a, try to not do that, alright? Like, try to, because if you do, you'll probably make a decision to regret.
I'm gonna try my hardest not to kill any.
Yeah, alright, okay. I made one of those before.
Well, I came from a family of assassins. What do you think?
Wait, what?
Audrey gets, like, that look of, wait, what?
Jack is happy to have a new friend and does not hear any of this.
Wait, y'all never heard of the Diceson family?
Are you, like, from some kind of weird mafia family or something?
You could kind of say that my family is split. One kills humans, one kills vampires. AKA demons in my language.
Vampires?
Yeah. That's what my master sent me over here to do. I think he's lied. I think he just wanted me to leave the monastery.
Alan is kind of speechless. Alright.
You'll know more about me later.
Alright, just be careful in the future. Alan tilts his head back to his neutral position.
She's going to look back at the guard. I'm so sorry about that. Can I ask, what's going on behind these barriers? I'm curious.
Oh, yeah, well, I'm sorry, miss. This area of the park's still under construction, so for your own general safety, we ask that you don't cross over this dashed line here. You can enjoy the rest of the park down that way as the batting cages. Adjacent from us is the park. The park park. He tips his hat. Oh, that's a dumb way to put it.
Audrey just gives a nice smile and...
And, Audrey.
Yes?
You're talking to this guard. You're like, oh yeah, what's past there? What's in this off-limits zone? Your curiosity can't seem to be restrained. You hear his words, but then you notice something. A door opening, and the click of heels as someone walks out of the off-limits building.
Oh shit!
God dang it!
It takes a few steps, walks away, but as she walks away, you swear she almost looks over her shoulder back at you. Keeps going.
Can I do something really dumb?
What are you gonna do?
I'm gonna look at the lady, at this person here, and be like, excuse me, are you a worker here as well?
Is she calling at this mysterious person back
She's
here?
She's calling at the mysterious person. She's just gonna say, like your earrings! Full of necklaces! Goku, you know?
Why would you say that?
She keeps walking, it doesn't... But Audrey... You feel like she heard.
Audrey's just gonna look disappointed. I wanted to ask about her earrings. It hurt his. I don't know.
The guard, like, looks down at you, looks back. Who are you yelling to? There shouldn't be anyone back there. Workday's over.
There was this woman or man with cloud earrings behind you guys. I just wanted to get your attention to catch up to her and see what she's going on.
He like starts to unhook a thing. Hey, Hoss, you want to go investigate it?
Oh, fuck, what?
I don't know. Kid says she sees some lady back here. It could be nothing.
I'm too tired for this shit. It's probably nothing.
Come on, it'll be 5 minutes.
No.
He walks past, and as they walk past the tired guards, they leave it unhinged.
And Audrey looks at everyone. Okay, everyone, I'm so sorry to say this right now. Do you guys want to explore a conspiracy theory in a way that I'm now finally thinking right now?
Sequence break.
I mean, this might be a horrible, horrible idea.
Drachma looks over. Oh yeah, this under construction ride looks amazing.
I already kind of have a record, so I don't want to get caught. Like, this would probably be breaking some kind of law, so...
Listen, Alan, I know, I can understand that fully, but something weird. First, we have that girl over there. I never caught her name. What was her name, Drachma?
Bounce.
Sure. We're friends now.
Bounce.
Oh. Audrey.
Yeah, I have her number.
Oh, hold up. Yes, my little friend who tried to steal information. What's going on?
I am a spy.
I know you are. Thank you for hearing me. What did you learn from her as Drachma was distracting her? I'm sorry, Drachma. I did a bad...
Ladies are not funny.
What? Wait, were you doing some, like, weird undercover, like, spy nonsense or whatever?
She gave off this weird feeling of she was someone that, like, maybe we need to keep an eye on. So I'm glad that Drachma got her number, but I don't know. I just have a bad feeling about her, and then the woman I saw back there. I want to see what's really going on, you know? Like, don't you see? It's like full conspiracy theory here. I can...
Or it's just a construction site and we'll be arrested.
Yeah, but you never know, Ellen. Experimentation and trying to figure out what's going on is the best. But the idea of, like, this...
Tali, please, no.
So many areas? Maybe there's a secret basement. I don't know, but, like, I'm a scientist. I want to explore every possibility that is possible, hypothesis and theory. I have an hypothesis of saying if we go through these barriers, we'll find something much bigger than we think. Because who would have those big earrings back there? And how, Bilshoff, can you describe what you found back there with that woman?
It, like, if it could shrug its shoulders, it does.
Smell funny.
Smelled funny. Can you remember what kind of smell she had? Or, like,
didn't smell tasty. Smell. Didn't want to eat her.
Little shop, what's tasty to you?
You.
Really? Thank you!
Drachma. She's gonna sigh and. Just pats her in the head. Pat, pat.
You tried to do that. Drachma is 6'6".
I reach up and try to do it. I reach up with tiptoes. Pat, pat.
Alan, think of it this way. Think of it this way. Alan, you look at Drachma. He's serious. He does this once in a while.
I tilt my hat downward in recognition.
Think of it like this. I think I'm starting to get it. Mom sent me here for a reason. I've made friends, which is probably one of them. What's life if you don't get adventurous? It's like she says. It's not a crime if you don't get caught.
Alright, that's a bad way to look at it, first of all. But second of all, I may have an idea on how to know what's back there without actually going back there.
Oh. I can understand that, Alan. I truly do. It just... Do you mind if I go at least? You guys don't have to come with me. It's okay.
Oh, I'm going. I go wherever my friends go.
I'm serious. I think I have a verse for this. One second. He flips through his book. So I'm gonna need you to go into there, but not actually go into there. Like, walk that way, and try to go to some kind of secret base or whatever.
Okay. Drachma's already walking there.
Alright, I'm using my stand. John 14:4, and you know the way to where I am going, specifically on Audrey.
Okay. You say the verse. Audrey, where are you going?
I want to follow the man lady. I couldn't get a good glimpse of.
Cool. You show up at the end of this hallway. Just you are put 30 feet forward.
No, this kind of mentality is kind of like how I graduated college in an early stage.
Drachma looks. Really? You'd get along great with my mom then. She says stuff like it's not cheating if you don't get caught, it's not a crime if you don't get caught. Laws are made to oppress others.
Check.com/later.com. Gotta talk to the professor, get some little knickknacks. That's why Little Chop of Horrors is pretty great on that, but it have been pretty nice.
Hold on, give me a moment. Drachma runs over. If you're worried about your face getting recognized, plot point. There's a cowboy handkerchief in Alan's pocket. He puts it around his face. the masked creature.
Doing this.
So, you guys continue to, against some of your better judgments, walk down the off-limits section of Misney Planet, Wizardtopia. This area is under construction, of course, yes, and it becomes immediately obvious as you continue inwards that As night begins to fall on the park, not only are you alone, but it seems that everyone is going home.
Oh.
You are at the bottom of the map.
Oh dear. Already?
Audrey is going to look super sneaky and be like, Ellen, wait, sorry if I'm going to push a little buttons here, but you said you were incarcerated, right? Did you used to do, like, sneaky things like this before?
I was incarcerated for a single action.
I see. Don't worry. Dino, do you think you know how to sneak better than I do?
I mean, I don't know. I don't know your background, but it was more of a kind of, whenever I fought someone, I was more of a guns blazing kind of guy, so probably not.
If you want sneaky, I'm here. I just gotta send Waterfall out.
Audrey gives you the snap fingers of, oh yeah! But then have a nice merc. No, I do have some experience of that, but that's a long story. And it just gives you a solemn smile and sneaks and whistles like doom, 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 doom.
Is she actually doing, is she actually humming while sneaking?
Yes.
Oh my god.
Stupid.
May Drachma have been, while they were walking, looking up under construction sites in Misney Planet, because he's curious about this weird ride under construction.
Yeah, sure. You find that it's a new roller coaster being installed.
Ooh. Oh, wait. Wait.
What?
This isn't already a ride? Alan?
Are
we actually doing something illegal?
I told you.
I thought you were doing the bit. I thought that was the bit of the ride. I thought we were supposed to be role-playing. I went, no.
What do you mean, role-playing?
Oh, I don't know.
Audrey's gonna give Drachma and Alan, like, the shh and the what was his name from Friends? Was the one that does the arms of quiet, please.
I hate to interrupt this, but right. Audrey. Again, you just happened to be in the right place at the right time. Audrey, you hear a giggle. Coming from really close by, actually. It seems to be, I guess, somewhere around this structure of boxes and crates.
Only I can hear this.
No, everyone hears it. It's just you happen to be the closest. King would also hear this. Alan and Drachma are talking.
Oh, I'm going to spend a plot point and say, remember all the items that I gathered? Are able to be sharp. I made myself, before walking over here, a makeshift knife.
Okay. You could just plot point yourself a knife.
I plot. Sure. I'll plot point myself too.
Come on, cat. Bobby knife. Pin knife.
Bobby pin knife.
I was just gonna say you're a botanist. You have gardening gear. Knives are important.
Yeah,
broken pair of scissors.
She brings a pair of scissors and knives, and he holds them together. And she's gonna be prepared, and as she's prepared, she's gonna try to climb over this sneakily.
Oh, you're gonna just climb over it, huh?
I'm gonna climb over it and try to hide.
What do you think for just hiding, Kat?
Brains
makes sense, yeah. I'm not going to tell you the results of this roll, because nothing immediately happens.
Does Audrey at least see something when she goes over?
You looking for something?
Just to see where the giggle come from.
What directions do you look? Where specifically?
She's going to look under and forward.
Right. Well, you don't see anything.
She sighs in relief. Oh, thank goodness.
Have you ever tried to look up?
Where are you looking up, King?
I'm looking up where Audrey is at Well, I'm going to go over to where Audrey's at, and I'm going to look up.
Alright. King, up in the boughs of the tree above Audrey, you swear you see something in the darkness. It's smiling at you.
Oh.
I keep forgetting how cute he is.
I'm gonna pop this back up again.
Keep playing. Aww. Game. You're gonna
we don't have a smiling one. Shame.
I didn't make a smiling one. It's okay. And King, you notice as it sees that you've spotted it, the smile fades and it kind of flutters underneath the boughs of the tree and it goes behind this bush over here.
Did I hear the rustlings up in the air?
You don't, actually.
Ooh.
Can I do something real quick? Can I empty out 25% of my water from my sheath tank so that I can summon waterfall?
Yeah.
So I summon waterfall with that. And how much water is around us?
Not a lot.
Okay, then. I have to use humidity.
Yeah, Audrey, you don't see that, but King, you most definitely saw something up in the trees.
I'm not gonna send waterfall after it. I'm gonna send waterfall ahead of where the sound would be closed, so I just send it behind the lights.
Audrey is gonna look at Alan and Drachma and give them the okay sign and the come follow me.
Okay. Let's, he looks back. Have the guards returned?
Yes.
They're back at their posts. Yeah.
Okay, let's go. We're gonna have to find another exit if we don't want to get caught. Oh no, if we've done, what have we done?
If I'm seen, I'm gonna have to get a new pair of velvet sweater and black hat.
Tommy, I thought this was just gonna be a haha funny joke, not an actual crime. Why didn't you tell me?
Nah, we in the hood.
I can't believe you said that, Karen.
Let me have a gangster again.
Audrey will hear in the hood and will turn around and be like, "Yeah, what the hood," and try to do like that weird, cringy gangster sign.
What inside of the car? What about a hood?
Yeah, snake core.
Oh God.
Drachma has the face of a person who just ate a lemon and is just like, in the hood, yeah, totally.
Alan has visible immediate regret, even though you cannot see it past his handkerchief.
Oh no.
Like, muttering to himself, why did I do this? This was a horrible idea.
As you're all kind of tense, you hear in the distance, you swear, what the hell is that noise?
Guys, I think my theory that something's big going on has been concluded.
Probably.
And she's going to chuck Little Shop. This bush.
Oh god, I know
it. There's another way out, so we don't have to go past the guards again.
I have a feeling that we might have to. This is like a secret
entrance.
Audrey
is going to signal Little Shop to stay put and be silent as possible.
But it does not, because it's a Little Shop.
Little Shop starts eating a rose bush.
Okay, that's okay. She just smiles and be like, oh, thank goodness. Does any of you guys know how to drive that thing right here?
I wouldn't put it past you, but that's a bad idea if we're trying to sneak.
I know, but like...
Drachma looks over at it. I don't like cars for reasons.
Oh.
So is that why you put up in a horse?
Well, that and horses are just cooler.
Horses are an extraordinary creature. I do say so myself. But there's no time for this, guys. We need a sneaking plan. King, can you do your assassiny thingy, majiggy, and try to go up like Ninja Gaiden 7 up in the roof, please?
What? Okay, hold on. Can you make that a little bit clearer so that I know what to do properly?
Sneak and try to find high ground. Like Obi-2 Kenobi.
Oh, you want me to pull out a Tachi?
Sure.
Waterfall. Go to higher ground. Above the stairs.
Audrey just looks super excited. Oh my goodness, I'm going to find something big here.
But you need to calm down. All of you need to calm down before we get ourselves killed. I've done missions like this before. And got myself almost close to killed.
I know, but it's exciting. We're gonna find some new discoveries over here. What if they're making brand new technology for plants? A flower garden made for perfection. Don't you think it's wonderful?
Looks back at the security guards. Maybe we should get going now.
Are the security guards coming in?
I don't want to risk it. Let's just go. Drachma moves the plot forward.
Drachma, hide yourself.
He hides behind.
Audrey is gonna go to the rose bush here and blood sign for Little Shop to say, hey.
Hey, King, I have a question.
Well, King was over here,
yeah? You were. Yeah. Right? You over here?
Yeah, I just stay over there.
Can I do it then?
Yeah, go ahead.
Cause, alright, King. You're over here, right? You have activated a villainous action.
God dang it.
Oh no.
The villainous action is called Can Your Friends Go Poof? If one of the PCs separates from the group and is currently out of sight of the others. King, you see an incredibly bright flash of light.
My eyes!
Oh shit!
You see this.
Oh, it looks so cute!
So you're the little bugger that I saw.
Now hold on, King. Hold on. You see a bright flash of light, and then that flash of light is gone. And it's almost like nothing happened.
That was weird.
And was Audrey, like, because she was closer, technically closer to King, see the flashing light, at least over the hedge?
You would have seen a bright flash of light, actually, yes.
Oh, Audrey is gonna peek out super fast and be like, King, you okay?
I don't know, I'm scared, because I don't know if that flash of light meant that he put some type of effect on me or not.
He's going to automatically now set a secret, the last secret action she can do.
Guys, I have a bad feeling. I think
that is entirely justified.
Were there any bad effects with that flash?
Just a flash of light.
You feel fine.
You feel fine. Yeah.
Okay.
That's scarier than anything else.
Spots in your vision from the bright light because it was bright.
Yeah, it was real bright.
All right, so I'll just jump off the tires and try to land on the bush.
Okay, that's.
Hey, I have a... Audrey, you said you don't know what stands are, right?
I don't know?
Well, last time we almost died.
Yes,
we did not almost die in that situation.
You almost fell into the fog.
You were suplexed, Alan.
I was suplexed, but that's very different from almost dying. Okay, this is splitting here, so let's continue, please.
Drachma actually worried. Well, I at least think you should know my stand ability. My stand, friends on the other side. It allows me to make contracts with those who have passed on. But, like myth or legend, there are ghosts. Beings that still continue to walk this earth because of lasting regrets or other reasons. My stand helps those that cannot pass on. I can contract with them, and give them the ability to interact with the world once again by becoming a part of my stand.
He hears that and just like, wait. Ghost?
Yeah. This is Tommy. Tommy.
Audrey's gonna look at Tommy and give him the gangster sign again of cringiness.
I smack her hand.
Ow! Ding!
Stop it! That's very annoying, and I feel like that's very offensive.
I don't think it's offensive. I think it's more like it's probably what he knows, maybe? I don't know.
He's from... You don't know different gang signs. That is very strong because some gangsters could actually kill you because of you doing that.
I guess so, but like, hell, I cheated death before. I can do it again. It's okay. And she just rods back without even saying anything.
Drachma picks up Little Shop.
We might need some surveillance over there, Drachma.
Mr. Goldham trying to be a spy.
He's trying to be the best spy in the camp.
Drachma leans in real close to Little Shop. You know what's better than hiding in a rose bush?
Getting a rose bush.
Hiding as a rose bush in a weird guy's coat. And he puts him in his coat.
I'm court bush. Audrey, I'm a court bush.
I see that. Job, Little Shop. Do you mind being his eyes and ears from behind?
I'm gonna be his mouth.
Okay. Just tell him if you smell anything fishy behind him.
Why?
Okay?
Yeah, no.
Because we don't know what's gonna happen.
Yeah.
Okay. Be safe, okay, buddy?
Well, quick question. Does anybody have anything that they're okay with breaking? Like, you wouldn't be sad if it broke, right?
Wait, can I just destroy the boxes? Can I just destroy the boxes over there? Would that work?
Wait, no. If you're saying that, we need to break something soft and that is easily not noisable.
Looks at this rose.
Looks at that rope. It's like a rose, but with a P.
Audrey's gonna look at Alan and give her the "Don't you dare hurt those roses" kind of look.
Well, I'm sorry to tell you this, rope, but you're gonna have to go to a good cause. Drachma takes the rope. Hey, Little Shop. Can you cut this rope like a super secret spy with a super secret laser cutter? Except your laser is your teeth.
I got laser teeth. What do we?
Yeah, yes. Cut the rope with your laser teeth.
Yeah, no, cut with the laser teeth.
It noms.
As Tommy reaches out to, well, the after image of the rope, what it looked like when it was whole, he has had this shadow. He's always just been this shadow around, like it's like everything else on Philotas. But as he absorbs it, the light there starts to be a neon colored light that starts to glow in him. It's dull, but it's there.
Audrey looks amazed by how this ghost is appearing and, like, writes in her notebook, "This could be a scientific discovery."
Little Shop is trying to use its teeth like lasers on the barrel.
Now Audrey is going to look at him and be like, "You know, Drachma, you can be very useful to paranormal investigators, right?
You know he could be a cop, right?"
Drachma thinks for a moment. Ghost detective.
I feel like we should have like a moment together and just like say, if we do not get away with this, thank you for enjoying my time at least here.
Yeah, we're all friends here. Yep, he's Dragon's glad to have friends. But but we should get serious. I don't think you all have noticed, but it's pretty dark out and we're probably gonna go to prison if we get caught, so maybe we should go on ahead because this is our only escape. And there's probably an evil stand, and there's probably a chaos stand running around, and just been
speaking of that,
a nervous mess.
Drachma, yep. Audrey, behind you, you do start to hear the small murmur and footsteps, and you see the flashlight beams of the two security guards from earlier walking down towards
we
you.
We got to go. We go.
Drachma grabs a little shop. Let's move.
We bucket. Go. Waterfall. Follow us.
I vault over this stuff. Careful not to make any obvious dents in the tape.
Little jump back in the pocket now. Are you okay with that, Drachma?
Yeah, Herbert throws Little Shop into your pocket.
Anyone need help getting up here?
Audrey just smile from seeing all these people just having fun, just running, and just say, "You picked the right friend, Audrey." snippity snappy.
Go ahead and look around the map.
Why is there just a big king there? What does that sign say?
Warning, construction ahead.
So where are we going? Left or right?
We should not split up.
Yeah, I don't. We shouldn't, because I have a bad feeling that that flash had done something else.
No, I saw the flash, and that's why I'm worried of not going to the ground. So let's stay together, and let's just stay on roofs. Let's try to climb a tree, go on the roofs, and jump from building to building.
Just in case, Herbert, can you stay with
that? That will create a lot of sound and probably get us caught.
Just in case, Herbert, can you stay with Audrey and Alan?
I'll stay with you with Audrey.
Bounce.
Alright, I guess we're going this way then.
No, wait.
Or that way.
We shouldn't be splitting up, that's why everybody should have a buddy.
If we're doing buddy system, then sure. I'll buddy with Drachma.
Audrey is gonna sigh, but they'll have a nice smile and be like, "We got this."
Okay, by the way, Hubert is following you. So, can you group up with him real quick?
Yes, Hubert, come with me.
I'll stay with Audrey.
Audrey is gonna be right by the bulldozer.
I'll go up top.
Hey, Audrey.
Little shop looks over.
It's hiding.
It's in a barrel.
You see, you smell anyone, you smell anything. Not just us.
Precision with Little Shop.
I want him to smell if there's any flesh.
Other than like you guys, you definitely smell some other flesh, though it's strange.
What do you mean by strange?
You'll have to find out. It's coming from that direction.
Little Shop wiggles its nose.
They're that way.
I'll send a waterfall over there.
Hey, Little Shop. More rope.
Little Shop noms the rope.
Tommy will eat the ghost rope.
Hey, I just realized, can Audrey taste the rope?
Yeah.
Audrey is just gonna cough a little bit, like... Oh.
Time to be a hero. Drachma scrambles over the boxes.
Drachma, stop it. Not now.
He stands right here. Okay.
I'm gonna go send a waterfall over there. Do not do anything stupid. I'm going to go check this out with waterfall. Which way did you say it was coming from?
The direction you're going.
Alright, so... I'm going to try to get him to high ground, so... I'll say right there.
What is that? What is that thing?
What is that?
What is that book that was that God forgotten? And it can only love something but himself, and even that is hated by himself. What is that monster?
Ali, do you want to play the music? Yeah. Play the music.
God, Jesus, no.
What? We pray at night. We stop at night. We're the rats. I'm the giant rat that makes all of the
Wiki rat.
Let's see what kind of rats we can dash him into. Oh my god, you're joking.
He's just standing there in the line. And, Kat, yeah, does this seem like a good time for it?
Yeah. Let's...
No.
Oh, no.
God, no.
You guys, welcome to the roaming bot.
No! Ricky Rick!
Why? You see... The iconic mascot for the park. Though, there's... The scent of meat was definitely coming from him. You can see, like, stitches? Like, where his hands meet the gloves, where his neck meets the rat face, where his rat ears are, on his arms, on his clothing, covered in stitches. And I'm gonna do this, this is probably gonna be terrifying, of... He turns.
Oh, no. Oh, that's so disgusting. Ah, can King see this?
Yeah.
He's about to hurl.
And Ricky Rat's going to hold his turn. Ricky Rat's gonna go last.
Okay, I'm going to try... How much water does Waterfall have on him again? Does he have 25 with Waterfall?
Yeah.
I'm gonna use 10% of that to make a trap in front of Ricky Rat and try to make it look sneaky to where he doesn't see it.
Go ahead and roll precision.
May I make a suggestion?
Yes.
A tiny water mouse trap.
You don't think he saw it?
All right. I will try to hide Waterfall as best as I can, so that I can try to do a sneak attack later.
Sure, it sinks in between the boxes.
Or because it gives off light.
King.
Now for King.
Drachma was whispering to you.
King, maybe we... It's probably just a guy in a mascot, right? Like, Drachma looks over from here, not having the advantage of seeing through Waterfall. He's probably just a mascot, right? Maybe we should just come clean, explain the situation to him, and maybe he'll let us go, right?
Don't. Right? I've dealt with psycho killers like this before. I had to hunt them down, and they were wearing a stupid costume.
If we do that, you know that we'll be caught, right? We should not be caught.
See... We just need to hide and let our stands do the work, so we need to hide our stands as best as we can.
Audrey is just looking so terrified and, like, doesn't know how to talk, but looks at it, menacingly looking at it, and was like, God, it's like one of those short stories from KeepingNoodles.com, abandoned by Misney.
Stay down. I'm going to stay where I'm at, but I'm going to just stay a little bit lower.
All right. Photos.
Oh boy, the friends.
Friends.
Fun fact about the stand. It's fully autonomous.
Yep.
I can make suggestions, not commands. So Drachma's just gonna say, okay guys, listen, this is probably just a guy, let's just stay stealthy, and Tommy, I know that's gonna be hard because you're glowing right now. Tommy is glowing right now. But I'm sure if we just stay stealthy, just stealthy, everything will be fine. He looks over Ricky Rat. You know, they made him look a lot nicer on the posters and, like, the ads and stuff.
Audrey is going to look at Little Shop and say, Little Shop, to me.
Little Shop doesn't come over.
God dang it, Little Shop, please.
It's trying to be stealthy. If it listened to you, it would be seen.
I might have some tasty food for you. I need you to go do more stealthy things. I need to chuck you.
It comes over with a sardine in its mouth. You don't know where it got it.
Okay, you can eat the sardine first.
Nom,
Are these boxes just a sword with fish? Is this a fish-themed roller coaster?
Wait, do I get something from the sardine?
Half of a utensil. It's the handle half. You don't know what utensil.
Mr. Okay. Utensil.
She's going to give Little Shop both in her teeth, a half utensil as a knife, and her other knife so that he chomps on it and becomes a flying, spiky Little Shop.
Gave the plant baby a knife.
Yes, I did. I gave plant baby a knife.
Plant baby has a knife.
I'm going and hoping this works, seeing that we have lights over there and lights over here. I'm gonna try to make this entire place lightless. I'm gonna chuck Little Shop to cut the wires of this light to make it not shine bright at their direction.
Okay, give me a bronze roll. It just bonks into the lights. They don't really move. They seem to be very stable because it's a construction zone.
Not even the knives penetrate?
There's a dent.
Oh.
Audrey, that's not stealthy.
I'm sorry. I just... Does Audrey see that there's like a plug near the lights?
Like the plug for the lights, like, goes way off this way.
Crap.
And then, as well as, like, this one goes off, connects, it goes off that way.
Crap.
You could try cutting the wire.
I'm gonna cut the wire. I do want to cut the wire.
You can move Audrey, but you won't be able to cut the wire this turn.
I'm gonna move her behind this box. He's just gonna look at King and be like, King, you work good in the dark.
I am. It's just I have to play very precise.
That's all I need to know, and that's her end of the turn.
Hey, I think I just realized something. Didn't those guards say that nobody was supposed to be back here? That can't be a mascot.
Oh.
Then why is it? Why does Little Shop smell flesh?
I don't know what his deal is here, but I think. What if we just sneak around this guy?
Alan, I have a plan.
Please tell me it's a good one.
Don't worry, it's great.
What's your plan?
No, trust me. Don't worry, it's great.
What
are you doing?
No.
Trust me, it's great.
No, I'm sorry, I'm going to have to ask you what your plan is.
Don't worry about it. Please, trust me.
Drachma, please, don't do something stupid.
Don't worry. If it goes wrong, I have a plan. I have Tommy to back me up. Don't worry. You know, wink.
Backing you up by, what, that thing?
You'll see me. You'll see. I'll be fine.
Caught. Okay. I think we should just avoid this problem in the first place. Maybe I could use that new teleporting verse or whatever. So, I might be able to teleport myself past him. I'll get close to him just in case your plan or whatever doesn't go through, okay?
Okay.
Alright. So, I'm going to use my, John 14:41, and I am intending to go here.
Okay.
And I'm using the verse on myself.
Cool. You get there.
Okay. 2, 3, 4, 5, and kind of hide behind whatever this is.
What is that, Tyler?
I thought it was like a workbench that they set up for like a lunch break or something.
Yeah, it's a table.
All right, I'm under the table.
Ooh.
So, I am going to try to sneak to Audrey super fast, and I'm going to try to get Audrey to slice my hand so that I can activate something later.
Wait, what? Wait, what?
There's a reason why I'm doing this, and it's if I'm trying to be sneaky, then this is like the only time that I'm gonna be able to do it.
Audrey doesn't know what you're doing, so.
So, King is going to try to sneak over to you. He's going to land right beside her, and he's going to say, Audrey, you have to try to cut my arm so that I can activate something for later.
What do you mean I need to cut your arm?
Can you just please do it? It will make so much sense later.
Ugh, crap. Does Audrey have anything to cut his arm? Or can I not even do that?
You have scissors.
I'll pull out the scissors and just say, fine.
Cut the back of my arm, not the part where my vein.
Okay, the back of the arm. I feel like I should say give it to Little Shop, but I don't know what you're gonna do.
But bring Little Shop over here. I think he's gonna give you an item if I can do this for
you. Just give it to him. I don't care. And she'll cut your arm with the scissors. Do what you need to do.
Hold on
a moment. King. Audrey.
Yes.
Even though King just asked this of you, even though you're going to cut his arm, at the moment before the blade gets right next to it, his arm just jerks away from it.
What?
Uh-oh. What? We're in danger.
And...
Does Audrey King, see anything?
You... That idea... doesn't seem like the best idea to you.
Alright.
Mind bullshit. So is it just Ricky Rat's turn now, or?
Yeah, I'll just stay right here.
Hello? Who's there?
Oh.
Come on out.
Oh, that's so creepy.
You don't gotta be afraid. Just come on out.
Ah, my life.
He does not come on out. Alan does the opposite of come on out. He comes out to a negative degree.
And I whisper to Drachma, I swear to God, if you come out here, I will smack
you
at the end
of
the
day.
How do you know my plan?
Because I know Drachma!
Oh, no.
GMs, may I trade Photos' turn with mine?
I think that's okay. Kat, are you okay with that?
I'm okay with that. The same entity, essentially. Ricky Rat's just gonna, like, kind of get a little defensive and, like, look around.
Drachma?
Yeah.
Drachma slips out of his cover. Hold on. One, two, three. Four,
we really do
five.
Not care this much about distance.
Stop it!
God damn it, Hashma.
Stop it!
You can dash as a secondary, you can go 30 more.
Okay. 6, 7, 8.
Yeah! I swear to God, I will meet you!
You're moving fast because it doesn't make sense to stop you in the fence. Hey, if you wanna, you can use your main action to go 60 more.
Yes. No! Stop giving him ideas!
Alan dies internally.
Hello there, Mr. Rat.
God dang it! Step away!
Mr. Rat. It's so nice to meet you. I'm such a big fan. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for all you do.
Alan face right. Cold.
Yeah. Are you and your friends, like...
Don't you dare say anything.
Going to, like, do something? Like, I'm just kind of waiting here.
Oh no, we're lost.
Oh, okay.
Don't say we, just say you!
Let's say you!
You seem
so what's your guard?
Going. Oh, I'm just mostly waiting for my friends.
Oh, your friends?
Yeah, we're, it's complicated.
I get it. Friends are complicated, but they're fun to have.
What's your name, kid?
Oh, Drachma Romani Facilier.
Oh, okay. You have your ticket?
Yeah, he takes it out.
Ricky Red is going to pat you on the shoulder.
Glad to see you made it.
Wait, do you know what the red on the ticket means?
We cannot talk here.
Holy shit.
You all did not trust me, but I find the deep lore.
I swear to God. You know what I'm about to do to Ricky Rat, right? Because of what you just did, I'm going to make the water in Drachma's pocket open up to give water, to get water flow, more water, and to chain Ricky Rat's leg to one of the boxes.
King, what have you done?
Oh, what happened?
What happened?
I can't lie about this. That's so good.
Show it to us. What is it?
Ricky Rat just takes a step forward as the water chain goes by.
Listen, you can tell your friends that I'm not here to hurt them. I've actually been waiting for you guys.
Oh, okay.
I was actually waiting for another group, but they never showed up.
I'm sorry that they're late.
King is just taking a lot of stuff into precaution just in case something bad happens. That's why he's been doing.
Is it Photos' turn now?
Yes.
Okay. This one has not been claimed yet. What comes down is a rather menacing figure who slowly puts his hand on King's shoulder. Listen to me, young assassin. Our leader is one that is capable in bending the wills of others with his charms. You may call him foolish. Many have before. But he looks over at Drachma. But he made a friend of me. And if you are his friend, you will trust him and his instinct. And that's his turn.
Oh my god, you're gonna make King cry again. Jesus Christ!
I'm gonna pull a Drachma, and she's gonna come out. She's gonna go have Little Shop with her.
Pick up a plant.
And she's gonna she's using all her actions for this.
For the meh meh meh
meh. And meh. Oh, Little Shop, come back. And she's going to walk up with Drachma. Hearing the spiel, she's going to look at him with a full, honest trust of doing good. I trust you on this. And she's going to lend out her hand. Be like, hi, Ricky Rat. Audrey. Moranis.
Nice to meet you, Audrey.
And he shakes her hand. His hand significantly, like, meatier than
so
yours.
Fucking big.
Meaty claws.
Does it, like, squelch when she touches it?
No.
And just have Little Shop outside and be like, can you see my little friend on my shoulder?
Yeah, hello. Does it smell weird?
Yeah, I know I smell weird. You're gonna have to deal with it for a little bit.
Why do you smell weird? I wanna eat your face.
That's a long story. Do not eat my face.
I wanna eat your face.
I do not recommend it.
Little Shop gonna try to eat his face?
Don't.
Little Shop,
don't you dare eat his face.
Don't.
Little Shop is holding everything back because Audrey and Drachma are like, don't.
Drachma looks over at him like, I'll get you. I'll let you have some of my blood. You've never had my blood before. You can try some later.
I want Mr. Chocolate Buzz here.
Cowboy?
Alan is super conflicted right now. Like, do I go up there? Do I not go up there? Do I just, like, alright, fine. Oh. Alright, I'm gonna use my stand to do, like, John, what was it called again? John 4.
John 14-4?
Yeah, John 14-4, I'm using John 14-4 to, I won't go here.
You go there! Look at that!
Man, you're so cool, Alan. Drachma says that in character. Man, you're so cool, Alan.
Audrey looks at Alan and just smiles. It's a really nice book, you know?
Alan is keeping his distance.
Oh, right.
Yeah, Alan is keeping his distance. So anything I guess else? It ends my turn.
Okay.
Alright, I'll jump over to them. I'm kind of still scared. I'm still defensive, but I'll go over there. So I'm gonna jump off the box. I forgot that I did get some arcane physical ability from watching Renegade Parkour. Parkour.
Team just parkour.
Parkour. Yes. Did.
Renegade's not even alive yet.
Proto Renegade, her great great grandmother.
Her great 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 grandfather.
It would be just great, great, great. No, just one great.
I think that's the end of combat, right?
Is King scared?
I am defensive right now.
Audrey's gonna pat him in the shoulder and just give him the look, a kind look of, it's okay.
If you say so, but okay, okay. I'll take my hand off my sword.
Drachma looks at you elated. You trusted me. Thank you.
This is the first time I'm trusting anyone right now, so. Yeah.
I've lost my trust, but I put my faith in you now.
Thank you. Alright. Are you all. You all have tickets, I'm assuming?
Yes.
Yes, I do.
Yes.
Pulls out her ticket.
Cool.
He will take his ticket out the kimono.
Mr. Ricky Rat?
Yeah?
I have a friend who really, really wants to know, get to the bottom of this. She doesn't have a ticket, but she works for the park. Her name's Pepper. And I think she would really like to come here.
You can't talk here.
Oh?
Yes, ma'am.
I think Cloud Lady might be around here.
Well, if she is, we need to move.
Like, you know her?
I'm just ending that because it feels like combat is not, yeah?
Combat? Yeah. It's... Oh.
What are you doing?
You befriended Ricky the man.
Y'all should just trust Drachma making friends more.
Audrey is just gonna look at Drachma and be like, you remembered what I talked about, the old lady.
Yeah.
He's just gonna smile.
The friends gave me a jump scare.
What are you talking about? They're just moving through, like...
What ghost was talking to King?
Garoba, the vaguely menacing one.
Oh.
The one at the bottom left. He looks at you, and nods. Like I said, our leader is a kind one. He deserves the trust. And look, paid off. You did the right thing, King. You are a good man.
Yeah, because I've lost trust before and faith in other people.
You put in the wrong people if it was broken. Put in the right one this time. And he's right over there.
Audrey, hearing about trust, kind of looks down, but a little solemn, and scratches her arm. Almost to the point that it's a little bit bleeding, but just doesn't feel okay after hearing it.
Can I heal her with my mom? I've done it before, Audrey. You need to stop.
She just sighs and stops.
Well, Ricky Rat, you said that you had somewhere to take us so we could talk?
Yeah, all of you are safe, correct?
Safe?
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 Fine,
what do you mean by
safe?
Yeah.
Like we're not going to talk to other people about it?
You're not in cohorts with them.
Oh yeah, we're not.
Wait, in cohorts with, he takes out the pin. S? We found this off of, like, a frog that attacked us.
Oh boy.
Yeah, no, we don't know anything about them. Like, we just found this off of, like, a frog.
I feel like we should throw it away. Did they have a tracker on?
You hear the sounds of... Well, first you actually feel the rumbling. Then you hear the sounds of, like, metal bars being shifted. And you notice as you look up, a cage starts to form around the entire park.
Oh, huh? Shit.
No.
Shit got serious.
We got caught like mice.
Drachma looks up, sweating. Oh no. Oh no.
Alright, I guess we're just not gonna walk out of here. Alright. If you all feel like you're safe, follow me.
Alright.
Okay.
This is... everybody? I have a bad feeling, but... this may be our one chance to figure out what's really going on in Misney Park.
Yeah, I believe it.
You stole my line, Drachma!
Ricky Rat shoves aside this metal box and opens up the manhole.
Drachma looks over at Audrey with a small, smug look. I'm the conspiracy theorist now.
Waterfall, come here. Need to go back into my tank so we don't run out of water.
Do you want to just unsummon him?
Yes, I'll put him back in the tank.
Ricky Rat opens up the manhole cover that's oddly placed.
Not the weirdest place I've been in.
Alright, let's go.
Alright.
We should move quickly, otherwise they will find us.
Yup.
Welp, time to play the second level of Super Dario Bros. Jumps down.
Everyone's going into the...
Yup, oh. For a moment.
Sure.
I want to see something. Besides Ricky Rat, as Audrey is gonna say, does you know that if we're being tracked at the moment?
Oh, you're saying that to Ricky Rat?
Saying that to Ricky Rat.
No, I don't know. But they'll find us one way or another, and if we get out of here fast enough, they'll spend the most of the time in this park.
And you're going
and she
in.
Goes in. Going in after Ricky Rat.
After Ricky Rat? No, Ricky Rat insists you go first.
Audrey is gonna insist that he goes.
You cannot first. Lift this manhole, trust me, you go down.
Baby, go down the manhole, you baby.
Audrey is just gonna sigh and be like, okay.
Audrey, what's taking up? Why are you taking so long? Come on, hurry up.
Just worried at the moment, okay? Just.
I was worried about Ricky Rat. What do you expect from me? I'm paranoid.
I'm sorry.
Audrey going down?
She's going down.
And Ricky Rat looks around real fast, making sure. So anyway, Ricky Rat's just going to gaze around, looking for a certain cloud-headed individual.
Ricky Rat doesn't see anything.
Okay.
We sewer level, boys. Guys. I had my friends scout around, make sure we weren't being followed. They'll report back to me if we are.
Alright. Stay together. Keep low. Don't make any unnecessary noise. Things above can hear things.
Can I at least whisper some things for myself?
Try to keep it so minimal.
Calm down.
Yeah. I could talk, but anything above a whisper.
She's just gonna whisper but sing just to keep her calm. Two lovers. Forbidden from one another.
Oh my god.
More
divine. She's a fucking Naruto lover.
Touch. Be together. Together as we go. Secret tunnel.
Secret tunnel.
Okay.
Secret tunnel.
Ricky Rat's going to take the lead, actually.
Audrey is singing wonderfully while whispering and terrified at the same time. You're shocked on how calming it is, this music.
I would try to pat Drachma for being a good boy, and I trust him now with all my soul.
Hey, King.
Yes?
Do you know what friend means to me?
What?
It means family. You're family now.
I've already had that feeling about you too. You're more of a family to me than my actual family is.
You know what? After this is all over, you need to come by to the diner. My mom's will fix you up a great old meal and we can talk about things. I don't know what.
You got alcohol over there?
Drachma looks at you. You know that'll kill you more than fighting, right?
I gotta find one way to take care of my PSD for my family.
Well, hey, guess what? You have me now, so you don't need to.
Alright. I don't trust you on that.
Audrey's just gonna stay behind a little bit. A little paranoid-ish, but just to stay behind and catch her breath a little bit.
Guys, come on. We don't want to be left behind. Come on.
Do you need me to carry you, Audrey?
No. It's okay. I'm just...
Now she needs you to be... Now she needs you to carry her.
No. It's okay. I promise. It's okay. Just...
Alright, you can drink the bottle of water if you want to now. If anyone wants to.
Alan makes kind of a, like, come on motion.
Drachma mirrors the come on motion. It's the come on Todd times two.
She's just gonna follow with a sigh. She's paranoid as all heck right now.
Audrey, calm down. I was paranoid at first.
And Ricky Rat begins to lead you into the sewers. And Tali.
Yeah.
Our final scene.
I am so ready for this.
Alright. Alright, so. Do you want to start this one?
Well, I think you have the better, like, how do I put it? Eye for it?
Alright, Thimble.
Sorry, it's not too bad with Jim.
A little bit on the nose. Or in the eye. And, Spectre just, like, Thimble, would you go over to the wall and pull the lever?
Oh, yes, sure. this one?
She pulls it.
Wrong lever.
Oh. What?
She, like, looks at the guy who's chained up in this cage. Looks back.
Why even bother have a lever that does nothing? Doesn't make any sense.
I don't know why we even have that lever. And Spectre turns the machine on.
And Spectre, as this man starts to get electrocuted, you get a call.
Oh, hold on. Spectre pulls out their phone. Yes, what do you want?
Spectre, hi. Yes? We've got some bad. I was fucking right, by the way.
About what?
The red ticket users. They're bad news.
Oh, how do you know?
Well, I just saw them going into the off-limits zone of the park. I followed, of course. I'm currently trailing them, but they've gone into the sewers and... the rat is out of the bag.
Oh, how did he get out? I had him trapped. I haven't checked on him, though. Yeah, I will check. I will see how he got out.
Old Holly, it's going on a little bit of a joyride.
Thimble, would you take care of this?
She starts, like, wringing her fingers together.
Oh, of course! I haven't seen good old Ricky in a while.
Maybe you can retrieve the rat for us.
Yeah, sure!
I know how much you had fun you had with him.
Yeah, of course.
Don't go too overboard.
You know me, I'm not over the top at all.
You're horrible at lying.
You know me too well.
Alright.
Alright, we will figure this out. Okay, anything else, Nimbus? Do you need me to call...
Her? Yes. Notify her.
I'll bring the cage down.
Alright. Good. I'll be back there soon. I'm gonna keep tailing them for a little longer. We'll see.
Are you tailing them or are you tailing them?
You can't see her, but she does air quotes, tailing them, you know.
Alright, do you know where Wizardtopia?
Yes. Just take the whole place, send the cage down.
Heard. Hurry up. I don't want to get this to get out of hand.
Spectre will close the phone.
Thimble.
Hmm.
Go have a little fun. I'm going to finish working on this one.
With pleasure. You don't need my help stitching this guy back together.
No, I actually need to take him apart.
Oh, that's boring. It's no fun when they're in bits.
I will let you put him into other things.
Okay, just make sure to keep the good parts for him.
He winks.
I cannot promise the eyes.
Mm.
I may need them.
Get what you want.
Yes, and you'll get the rest.
Mm-hmm.
No. Careful. Mm-hmm. The acid's built again. I know we just repaired the step, but oh well.
Alright.
Oh my god!
Guys, listen. It's the Drachma skip. It's a Drachma toxin. We're about to skip. Now we're at the final. We're at the final boss.
Hold on.
Let's do it again. You want to show them?
Hey guys, you don't get to choose.
We go to like four right away. We win. Baby.
Wait. What? We don't get to choose.
You beat the game.
You don't get to the area.
We're going to a secret area.
We're going to rank four.
Quick question.
Yeah.
Oh wait, no. I was just gonna say, Drachma's going to be a bit disappointed that I wasn't able to go visit the bumper cars that Pepper said, but he understands.
Oh,
you can call her later, buddy. It's all right.
Hey, you know I'm gonna try to recruit Pepper Misney into this, right?
Please call Pepper. I want you to. She's right. So good.
Shall I drag them back to the title screen?
Yeah.
Don't worry, I'll recruit Pepper after.
Are we going to the team A title screen?
Yeah, one sec. Where's the team A titles? Oh,
it's all the way on the other end. It's alright.
This wasn't much of a joyride.
This was like Five Nights at Freddy's right here. I'm sorry.
Oh no!
Oh, that went so well!
Oh man, I love Nicolas Cage.
Oh man.
Art time? I get to start?
I think you get to start, yeah.
With Small Tree.
Small Tree.
Do y'all not know what y'all done with King now?
Look at it!
Small Tree is baby.
Small baby. Small baby.
Ricky Red.
Hold on. Ricky before Red. That, the eye catch for the unknown stand.
Oh, yeah. Oh, and yeah. Audrey Eyecatcher. Ricky Rat.
Ricky Rat.
Wait, have we posted Nimbus actual artwork?
No, we haven't! Hold on. I can actually show Nimbus. Hold on, I gotta change the name.
I love Nimbus so much.
There we go.
Yeah, you do.
I know. There we go. Nimbus!
Bonjour!
I'm so sad she did not react to me saying nice earrings. Reminds me of Dragon Soul B.
Look at her.
Are they earrings?
Yeah, they actually are earrings, technically.
Oh, I forgot if they were earrings or her hair.
I don't know.
Wait, hold on. Are those earrings balloons?
They're just stupid.
That reminds me of so much Dragon Ball. This reminds me of, what if there was just little Goku's on there? That would be funny.
Exactly, little Goku hair.
I'll just use Botox to make little Goku figurines on her.
First, I'm gonna put out Pepper, because I know I'm posting Pepper here. Okay, hold on. Do you want me to post Ricky Rat Cat?
Yes.
Alright. This is by Duncan. It's Ricky Rat. Yeah.
Ricky Wet.
We won't even know his stand at all.
Nope, you didn't fight him. You chose not to.
I'm glad.
And can I post my favorite? I want a poster.
Do it.
Yeah,
do it.
I'm
gonna post Thimble. Yeah.
Yeah. I forgot about Thimble.
Guys, we're gonna fight a clown. We're gonna fight a Jester clown. Tali's gonna have so much power, we're gonna die.
I will either fight a jester who is gonna be referencing North, Hunchback of Notre Dame, or...
I mean, we already have one of those.
We have not doubled up on any references.
I got a question for Tali. Why did you say that I pulled back my arm?
I don't know. Why did I?